Hi there. I'm so glad that you decided to join me for this session because this section is just so important and it helps you so much if you have a good understanding of it now in grade 10, grade 11, and 12. So if you are proactive and ready to learn this section, let's go. I will leave a link to this mind map and also some notes in the description for you if you just would like that for yourself. Okay, let's look what we will learn in this section. So let's start at the top there with just some of the concepts that you already need to know before we start with this. So you need to have some knowledge of the Cartesian plane, plotting some points, reading points off the graph. We use substitution all the time and we solve equations the whole time. And then we just need to be mindful of everybody's favorite fractions. Let's start on the left and then work our way around. We're going to investigate the standard form of a linear function. So if you identify a certain form, you know, that must be a straight line graph, which is just a different name for a linear function. And we're going to look at finding the gradient. That's very important. We are going to learn to draw that. So if I am given my equation for a linear function, I am going to be able to draw that on a Cartesian plane. And then we are going to learn when you are given the graph, you then have to find the equation for it in its standard form. Then we're going to look at lines that are parallel. What do they have in common? Perpendicular lines. How do we use the one line to find the gradient of the other line if they are perpendicular? Perpendicular just means that they meet or they cut with a 90 degree angle, right? And then we are going to look at some special lines, some lines that are just vertical and horizontal, and how to write down their equations. So let's get going.